I published the demo for the internal playtest last month. Since then, I've received a lot of feedback, no matter it is about the game or the Steam page. I appreciate your support all the time. In this video, I would like to show you what I have done based on the feedback. Let's get started. Hi everyone, this is Lee, welcome back to the channel. If this is your first time here, you want to see videos about game development and programming, consider subscribing to my channel and turn on the bell, then you won't miss my next episode. If you follow the channel, you know I have been learning Unity for 1 year. I'm making a turn-based strategy game named Dungeon Slayer at the moment. The Steam page for the game has been published. You can add the game to the wishlist. One of the feedback I got is about the UI animation. Sometimes it is not consistent. I took some time to review all the UI elements and make sure the animation behaves the same. Some of the feedback is about the in-game UI is that the tooltip for the hero's ability is not clear. I decided to show it in the text. I hope the player can understand the hero's ability easily. I also add turn information for the heroes and enemies, then we can see who is taking action. Another feedback is about the usage for the luck bar. Some people think there are two health bars. I learned this mechanic from the game named Hard West, which is created by Creative Forge Games. I can see the luck system is not easy to understand, especially without the tutorials. So I decided to remove it from the in-game UI, but it is still used for the backend to calculate the hit percentage. The hit percentage is showing on the top of the enemy now. At the same time, I use a small value for health and attack damage instead. I think it's easier for the player to plan the strategy without doing a lot of math. Another critical feedback is that people want to see more varieties to the heroes, not just the appearance. I agree with it, I also want to make it easy for the player to understand it. For example, the wizard mainly uses the fireball to attack the enemy. It can bypass the obstacles. It is useful when the player wants to attack the enemy behind the wall or fence. The knight can trigger the push away by the distant attack. If the enemy is near the trap, we can push it into the trap. The barbarian can only make a melee attack, but this is a strong character with more health. At the same time, he will cause actual damage and push away distance. Once the enemy gets pushed away and bounce into the other enemy and obstacles, it will receive additional damage as well. Now we can differ the heroes by different attack range, attack damage, push away, and attack style. If you have any ideas about adding some interesting ability to the heroes, please feel free to let me know. I'm open to any suggestions. To keep adding the pressure to the player, I add the enemy spawn feature. I also modify the script to make sure not too many enemies spawn on the screen. And I can also define how often to spawn the enemy. The player can control the hero to stand on the top of the spawn point to block the enemy. It will also encourage the player to move the characters, not hide behind the obstacles all the time. I introduced some sort of hostage characters. The heroes need to save them and bring them back to the safe place. To achieve this, I modified the AI script to support this feature. Now we can see the hostage will follow the heroes at a certain distance automatically. After the heroes save all the hostages, the save point will be highlighted. Then the heroes and hostage should get back there as soon as possible. There are still a lot of places that need to be improved, but I hope you can see what I'm aiming for. Do you like these changes? Please leave a comment and let me know. Furthermore, you can always reach me from my Discord server. Currently, we have over 160 members. Please feel free to share your work there and get some feedback. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and turn on the notification. Your support is very important for me to make games and videos in the future. Thanks for watching, this is Lee. I will see you next time.